watching ITV Gold, and I'm your host Aditi Lama with cameraman Raja Bhatti. And currently, we are the very popular Taj Pierre Hotel, and today we bring to you an exclusive insight into Abujani Sandeep Khosla's new collection that has been brought here for Indian Americans in New York City. Today, we are going to have the honor to talk to Sandeep Khosla about what is currently happening with the Indian fashion industry and their beautiful journey as they brought together elegance, authenticity, and creativity to Indian fashion globally. Today, we will also be talking to key organizers and presenting you a beautiful collection that shows different areas of India, the true work of artisans, and the true presence and essence of handicrafts. And today, at this event, we also have an exclusive insight into Amrapali Jewelry, one of the leading brands of high-end jewelry in India. I'm Aditi Lamba, stay with us when we bring you Abujani and Sandeep Khosla inside. Today, I have the honor of having an awesome young South Asian woman standing next to me, MIRAI, the key organizer behind this beautiful event of Abujani, Sandeep Khosla, and Amrapali Jewelers. MIRAI, thank you so much for being with us on ITV Gold. Not only is it amazing to have like a fellow young South Asian woman, but I think it's amazing for you to bring such an elegant event. So, you know, what kind of inspired you to, you know, be in this industry and bring forth such a huge, you know, high A-list event to New York?
It's a very interesting question. I've actually been working in the industry for a long time. I was based in Mumbai before this, and I was working as a buyer for one of the premier luxury boutiques out there called Ensemble. So I've got my feet wet before, and I just love the entire industry. I love the glamour, and particularly the couture. And I feel like these days we're really missing that exclusivity and that high voltage, high glam factor. It's sort of going away with like social media and like everything becoming more mass and more like trend focused. Individuality is getting lost. And I think I wanted to bring back some of that with this event. So getting Abujani and Sandeep Khosla and getting Amrapali together was like an obvious choice, since they are the best in the business.
Just talking a little bit more about the event, you know, when you see the U.S. market over here interact with these designers and other artists, what do you think that interaction has been? And, you know, what do you see as the scope of that market for Indian American or South Asian consumers here?
Right. I think definitely India has really modernized in their appetite for silhouettes and colors, and everything's become much more edgy and much more sexy. I think the America is now catching up to that mindset in terms of Indian clothes, and they're slowly realizing that India is becoming much more modern, and I think that's great, and I think it's going to be a great collaboration in the future, so with all the designers.
And one last question for you. I have to ask you, it's a new line that they're showcasing. We're standing next to that too. And there's a few others I would love for you to walk us through in the camera. Talk to me about the line. What have you liked? What do you think has struck a chord with others? And, you know, you've had the opportunity to also interact with Sandeep Ji right now. So, like, you know, talk to us about anything you feel comfortable hearing.
Right. I think they've done a beautiful line, especially been curated for the American market. I think we're looking at a couple of different things here. They've got an entire Western line that I think is beautiful for, you know, galas and just like high glam events. So this is lovely. I know they've dressed a lot of U.S. stars and celebrities for the Golden Globes and the Grammys and things like that. So I think this is a lovely piece from their Khosla Jani collection. It's one of my favorites in their line. And then of course, as you go forward, you'll see many, many more lovely things. Yes.
This is amazing. It's gorgeous. It's well set up. It's beautiful. My friend Kajal and I decided to come, and well advertised. It's a great break on a sunny, on a snowy Saturday, Friday, Saturday. Come here, and it's beautiful.
It's very important. And Amrapali has been doing this for so many years. They're trendsetters. So their jewelry collection is gorgeous. And it's great for people here to get a little peek into what they do. And shoppers here have become very savvy. So most designers now have found a new home to come to in the US, and especially the New York market. Abujani and Sandeep Khosla's clothes are gorgeous. We are, both of us are in love with that ivory outfit. It's a visual treat for all of us.
Can we expect from your jewelry brand for this year? 2019 has kicked in with a lot of spirit and a lot of positive vibes. So tell us, our viewers, while we have you here on ITV Gold.
We're so excited. We have a stunning, stunning new collection. Very edgy, very funky designs. In addition to all our bridal work, like this is one of the pieces that we've just designed for 2019. So something a little bit of the East, a little bit of the West, and we're really excited. It's going to be a fun year.
It's time for a short break, but stay with us on ITV Gold as we bring you so much more from the Abujani Sandeep collection, a collection that is truly inspired by colors, by Indian handicrafts, and so much more. Abujani Sandeep Khosla brand is known for their intricate fashion techniques and also a big recognition to Indian artifacts. So if you look with here, when we were talking to Sandeep Ji, he actually pointed out some of these outfits such as this, in which if you see, it's very intricate details. All of this has been handcrafted. As he said, there are about hundreds of women that are working tirelessly in Lucknow and other parts of the country to produce different fabrics, different styles of Indian fashion on these outfits that are being produced everywhere and sold globally in this brand. Moving forward, he also spoke to us a little bit about the new line, which we'll be taking you to, and he talked to us about some inspirations behind it. Also, he showed us an insight into one of the oldest and the first pieces he made for the Abujani Sandeep Khosla thing. The ladies behind us, as you see, are looking through a collection that Mr. Khosla talked to us about. And he talked to us about getting chicken curry on different Indian fabrics. A really close association that's had with the Abujani and Sandeep Khosla event. And as you see, it's really gotten, you know, the eyes of everyone attending here on these pieces. I can definitely see that there's a lot of love for Indian fabric. There's a lot of love for ivory. What do you have to say about his design?
The work is very intricate, exquisite. It's one of the most beautiful Lucknowi chicken works I've ever come across. Awesome. It's absolutely beautiful, and everyone must own a piece of this.
Do you know they were one of the originals to actually create this kind of work? What do you have to say now holding this piece in your hand, knowing that?
Yeah, knowing that, okay, I've owned many pieces with Lucknowi chicken work, but this is really mind-blowing. It's really beautiful.
While I was walking with Sandeep Khosla Ji over here to sort of get his insight into what goes into making these beautiful designs and what truly inspires the brand, he totally was obsessing over the use of mirror work, and he actually took out a few pieces for us from here that we'll be showing on screen, in which he talked about the essence of mirror work in Indian fashion and how it's actually a very traditional aspect of it. Well, so much excitement here when we are seeing the entire community come together and celebrate Indian fashion. Stay with us. We'll be back right after a short break. everyone, you are watching ITV Gold, and I'm your host Aditi Lama, and we have today the pleasure and honor of having none other than Mrs. Sandeep Khosla, a huge part, obviously a very main part of the Abujani Sandeep Khosla brand, a designer duo that really embraced the elegance of Indian fashion, that truly have defined Bollywood, have transformed Indian fabrics, Indian design, and have truly brought an international standard on Indian fashion, a huge recognition. So, you know, starting this interview, I have to ask you, it's, you know, when I describe your journey, it's a journey well lived, well loved, and well executed. Over 30 years, so much work, generations of Bollywood even attached to it. How has it been for you?
It's been wonderful. We've been blessed, and we've always challenged ourselves to do better each time. And we've also, our competition has been ourselves. And so we blessed that we both challenge each other in a certain way. Also, we compliment each other in a certain way. And that the fact that we disagree to agree is wonderful, because that's how the best comes out. So we've been fashion forward most times, and we take risks. We're never afraid.
Mr. Khosla, while talking to you about your style and the journey, you know, you both come from very humble beginnings. You know, you have extensively talked about, you know, actually, you know, growing up in the arts and also not having a professional background, but having that love for Indian fabrics. Could you talk to our viewers a little bit about, you know, how the journey started and, you know, 30 years in forming this dynasty, how much work went into it?
It's been many hours of work. It's been many people behind it, because we've had artisans. We've employed over the last 30 years, we must have worked with at least 5 or 10,000 artisans who've, you know, been through our fold at some point in time or the other. The journey has been wonderful. It's been difficult. I want to tell the new generation that there are no shortcuts in life, you know, and you have to just work hard. You have to stay on point. Literally, fashion you can learn in a school or a college institution can just teach you discipline. But beyond that, creativity is something you either have or you don't have. So otherwise, everybody would be a fashion designer, everybody would be an actor, everybody would be a painter. So I don't think that you have to bind yourself, if I can't sketch, I can't do this and I can't do that. You have to have a vivid imagination. You have to have a belief in yourself. And also you have to create original somewhere along the line. You have to start thinking original, you know. It's tough, but fortunately we've been blessed. God's been on our side. And like I say, we're God's chosen few, that we have the talent. Because when we started off, there were no schools for men. There were no institutions for men in India with taught design. So all you had to come abroad. And neither of us could afford to come abroad. We didn't have, our parents didn't have the resources at that point of time in their life. So it was a struggle. And every day has been a struggle for 30 years, because when you're self-made and some collections do well, some don't do well. And as you're financing yourself every year, you know, it's been tough. But as you said, the best comes out of tough times.
And being original and having that attachment to Bollywood has truly sort of defined Abujani Sandeep Khosla brand. You know, when we talk about events, you know, the most elegant, the most high-end events, your name is always associated. A journey that started from Kapurthala, where your family still resides, to all of the places you've seen in the world. You know, what do you think has been the key aspect of it? And also talking a little bit about your business model, now that you have your niece working in it, do you think that has worked out the best for you?
That's worked out a huge amount. That's how we have five brands today, five labels under the umbrella of Abujani Sandeep Khosla. It's all because of her, because she came in 7-8 years ago and she infused a new energy and pushed us to get out of our classic routine that we were in. And said, come on, guys, you have it all. It's just go back to your risk-taking days and go back to where we started. And so she's been a mover and shaker, totally, where we are concerned.
Just talking a little bit more about it, I know we are running out of time here. You know, when you look at the growth of the industry, when you're looking at these beautiful displays that are now being brought into different parts of the world, what are your current hopes with the brand? And, you know, having your niece involved and having so many outlets, such as the Bollywood weddings you've done, what do you see as the next step for the brand?
The next step of the brand is to grow internationally and have a store in New York, London, Paris, Milan. Wow. Yes.
To ask you one last question for all our young South Asian designers, there are so many of us over here, you know, residing in New York City and parts of the US. What's an advice you like to give them? You know, what should their game plan be now with so much happening in the Indian fashion industry?
I just want to say once again, there are no shortcuts. You have to work very, very hard. There is no glamour in the industry. There's a lot of hard work. If you're ready to put in the hours, you will achieve, and literally think original. That's definitely the key.